Right, hello, I'm back again. It's night time, it's nothing at the moment, but let's have a quick look at what I've been doing in the meantime. See, all the grass blocks have now turned into, the whole area has turned into grass blocks, and I've installed a harvester, a chest, and at the other side another harvester back here, and those two harvesters go into this chest. But they need to be upgraded, so it's only at the moment it's just covering us three by three block. And I need to make that a bit bigger. And down below here, let's get to the air seal. I put a boiler. I better be careful. And you see already I've got a lot of stuff out of this. One sand, one tainted soil, gravel. Soul sand. Oh, fantastic! That means I don't have to. Well, I do have to go to Nether. I still need some Nether wart, mycelium, dirt. That's a lot, basically. Peat and heat sand, just from that small area and over a very short period of time. Don't ask me why. It's done some much prettier tasks. Let's see if I can jump up here. Yes, managed that for a change. And today, what we're going to do first. Maybe we should do a little upgrade first of all. Let's upgrade the harvester. Oh, I did also fix the piping on here. So now I move the tank and put it on top of the cyclic assembler. So now the cyclic assembler's got plenty of water in it and gets filled up as soon as I make something. And all I did was to take it straight out and just drop it down the back here. So really quite a simple, straightforward routing at the end of the time. And of course the same goes I can't see that. But that also goes into the igneous extruder. So the igneous extruder's also got water and lava coming in without any problem. We just have to make sure that we have enough LP in the network, otherwise we'll be have problems. And at the moment we have just kill a few more mobs, fill up the altar. Let's check what the altar's doing now. This is actually still going down, and I thought I'd fix this. So what am I going to do now? Current life essence, sorry, let's just try this one. Let's put the servo in here and then configure the servo so it's enabled on high. Okay, so I hope the switch now should turn it on and off. Maybe it's not close enough. I thought it should. I can't really think of any other place to put that. Let's dig it up. Where did that go to in the hopper? Huh? Oh. Where did that switch disappear to? Oops. Look what's happened. That's a bit bad. I've just got a quick. There was an explosion there which I didn't hear because the creeper blew up as I was at the end. But no problem. We can soon sort out these guys. In fact, this is actually turning into really quite a use. A lot more life essence and blood now coming through. Have I got another? Yes, I have. Good. Oh, there's my. Can we put it down there? Nope. Get in before it sees me. Right, back. See, okay, I'm working. So, I just don't understand what's going on with the switch here. It should work. Is there another place it's getting a redstone signal from? Because at the moment it's high enabled. It can't be high enabled. Didn't mean to do that. What's happening there? Never mind, we'll sort that out some other time. Let's just check what's going on in the altar. It doesn't seem to be going down anymore. Oh well, anyway. So I'm getting a lot more mobs being spawned in here, and I haven't shown you that either, but actually we can do that, I think, now. Have we got us? Someone's got a pickaxe with me. I don't think there are any mobs in there. I haven't checked very carefully. We'll take a risk. You see? And what I did is to put down, oops, there's a skeleton or something like that. I put down some, before I go in there, let me just get myself prepared. Oh, he can't get out of there now, he's stuck. Good. You see the conveyor belts dragged him into the centre bit. Even as though he's shooting at me, he couldn't get to me. But I can get to him, all right. In fact, if I use this one, it'll get you one time. There we go. And the bats, of course, are also getting pain, but making noises. So that was what the layout I've got there, and they get everything's getting pushed into the middle as they move around. So that works reasonably well. I should have plenty of stones. I do. Where are those ladders? There we are. A bit short look. Anyway, let's put the rubbish into here. Got plenty of rubbish as usual. Rotting flesh. Oh, and these artificial hives turned back again, didn't they? In fact, what I'm going to do is put those boots in. I don't need those with me either. Sort those, see what we've got. Okay, actually I could mend the two pickaxes there fairly. Saves me one space and I get a complete pickaxe. That's probably a good thing to do. Right, what I'm going to do now... Oh, I haven't made the man blade. We'll do that afterwards. I think I wanted to make some more... what do I want to make? Some reinforced slates. Let's move that out of the way and eat this. I'll do that when we come back, because then by the time we come back there'll be more stuff. So what I want to do, before I go, yes, I need to think a bit more and get planned. I want to take these scented artificial hives. Take those with me, because they didn't work here, so they do work sometimes. I have done it before, and I think you get something like a 10% chance. So let's just check our network. 15,000 jetpack is enabled, but I want to turn it off because I'm going to use the air seal to do a bit of traveling here now. You see, you can move fairly quickly. But I'm actually only going to go flying around. Just above ground. Funny. Just holding down the right mask button here, by the way. Right, made it. I wonder how much I used in our network. Have a quick look. 150,000 LP. Not much at all. Okay, so now we can use the scoop. And get these two hives and try placing these two hives with another one. Let's have a scoop. Here it is. I'll scoop that one up. We got some, that looks good. Actually, I think we've got some comb, which means I can do the honey drop. I'll put this one down in its place. We'll take this one as well. And put one up here in its place. Maybe we'll do a second one if we're lucky. We'll get to put it over this side. Here's a poppy. Let's take the poppy. Oops, no, it dropped off the side. What I should have done, of course, is to activate this sigil. Let's do that anyway. So if I want to take the dandelion, for instance, here, I'll just click it. It should pull it towards me. It's a bit of a small space, this. fact, let's put the other hive here. Exactly at the edge. There you go. I'll see what happens to those in a while, see if they've picked anything up. So what did we get? We got a pristine forest princess, I found great, and an ignoble meadows princess. That's a bit of a pain. At least we've got both princesses and drones, so we can actually start to do some breeding. We got two honeycombs, which is also good. Okay, back to base. Try and keep above ground. I've got to concentrate on this. It's actually quite difficult. Right, managed. Phew. And you'll see also that these flowers are also spreading like wildflowers, as it were. So what we need to do is put down the centrifuge, and I also moved everything out of the way here so I can get there much easier. I moved the quest delivery system and I removed the altar, and I've picked it up and put it away somewhere, so it was in here. So what we now need to do is to make some find some place to put the centrifuge. Let's put it here. Have I got it with me? No, it's in that chest, isn't it? Wrong one. Where has it gone? There we go. I'm also going to have to make a... I think this is the one I need for seeds, isn't it? And I think I can put honey in there. I hope. And with a bit of luck, we'll get honey drop. So we need, of course, one power. One conduit for power. Having remembered where it is eventually. Let's put that under there. Let's see what's happening here. And we're getting power coming up. Great. And it says I'm the owner, and we have our honey drop, which is what we needed. Now we've got nothing else in here for the quest. So let's right click the quest and see what we've got. Okay, we haven't done that one yet, but we have completed this one. We haven't tear stained. Make room. And that one, manual detect. Claim reward, fantastic, three quarters of a heart, and another canister. So let's put that canister in place. I can't do much with the heart, but I did get a full heart from one of the reward boats from the repeatable quest. Isn't that good? Now we've got to decide what we're going to do with the bees. Well, we will need to make some hives. So I'm going to put the bees in here to start with. If I actually managed to do this right. And for scented hives, we're going to have to... not hives, let's have a look. I've forgotten how to do hives. We need seed oil, I think. Oh, it's not a hive I want. What is it I want? It is an apiarist's... Let's have a look at forestry. I just can't spell today at all. Well, I'm not going to be able to do aviaries for a while. That's going to take a lot of work. But I should be able to do an apiary, that was the one. Or maybe a bee house. So a bee house is made with one comb, which of course we've now used up, wood. It's wood planks and slabs. Okay, so we need another comb. So how are we going to manage to do that? I think we'll have to go to an apiary first of all. So we need an impregnated casing, and this is what we need. Oh, we need a carpenter for that, and we need seed oil. That's what we need. Actually, not too much seed oil. And just logs around. It doesn't matter what the logs are. But with for seed oil, we actually do need seeds and a centrifuge, I think is what we've got. A centrifuge, no problem. So let's see what we can do. Plenty of mobs here at the moment. Let's just get the right sword into place. If I hold press this one and press number one, it swaps it with the one space. Now, how are we doing for blood? Because I wanted to make more slates, didn't I? Of course, it's after having done all that flying around, it's used all of the blood in the altar. In fact, it looks like it's finished. Yes, it's just trickling out through this now. Oh, this thing's a pain. Actually, and it isn't even turned off. Let's just try. Nope. But I've got plenty, so I wanted four slate, a stone, don't I? I've got, that'll be about 12,000. It's 3,000 for each reinforced slate. Look at this lot. So I put four of those in here. Let's go to the back there and see if we can reach the vacuum hopper, get rid of the rest of the stuff that I don't want. That looks like all of it. And we take out from here the, don't need the scoop at the moment, we've used that. Can I reach that? Yes, I can. Take those creeper seeds out now. So now I can simply almost leave those alone. There's not quite enough in there, it's 11,500, but one mob later, we got two, we'll give those plenty of capacity. So we got, while that's a sort of brewing, so to speak, let's go and make an upgrade. So the upgrade I want to do is for the harvester. And the one I need, I think it's an upgrade. What is it called? So the harvester, which... So the harvester is Mine Factory Reloaded. So let's have a look for Mine Factory Reloaded. Oh, actually, here we have the upgrades. So this is a radius increase of 2, tins 3, coppers 4, gold is, bronze is 5, 6, that would give you 9. So silver would be good. But we don't have silver, so we have plenty of gold. Let's do this one. So we need 3 raw plastic, 3 gold, and 2 redstones and a gold nugget. Not really a big problem. And we'll do this. We'll do a cheaper one for the other, which will be, instead of this, it'll be just 3 iron or something like that. We have even got a gold nugget here. So what do we need? Let's have a look. Gold is actually not in there. I probably haven't got any gold at the moment. Let's take 36 from here. Put those into the redstone furnace because that, as you see, compared to the another furnace, it really does go through here fast. So we needed plastic. And in here, I think I've got some rubber prepared. Yes, I have. I need 6. I want to do 2. I want to do one for the farm, as it were, and one for the aubrey. So we want to simply cook these up. So we've got 10, which is plenty of gold. Let's put these into here now. Which I can't do anything because I'm full of rubbish again. Oh, so this is finished. Let me just check what I've got in here. I've got bones and everything in here. It's ridiculous. Arrows, gunpowder, weapons. I'm not sure what I've got in there. We'll just take them out and see. Hopefully I've got enough, but... No, they're not reinforced. They're just blank slates. So I need 8,000 in there to get that out. And I haven't got it. distance. You really have to watch these, a bit of a pain. I hope I've got enough in there. If I'm not, I'll have to do a bit of self-sacrifice again. And I've still got a full inventory. See, every time you slay something, oh, it's because I've got this magnetism. It keeps pulling the stuff to me instead of going into the vacuum hopper. It's difficult to tell, actually. I don't think those are reinforced yet. Anyway, let's just put the stuff that I don't want into the vacuum hopper. Wow. And turn off the signal of magnetism. And check this. It should have done it by now, actually. They are still ordinary blank slates, aren't they? There we go. Got them. At last. So we shall put the magician's blood orb back in and take out this one bone. And get rid of the bone. Is there anything else I got picked up as well? No, just that bone this time. So right, back over here. And I got 6 slates, 46 obsidian. I want to make the upgrade, didn't I? That was the rubber I wanted. That's what I was doing. So the gold's been processed now, and the rubber. In fact, yeah, it's just ordinary rubber. I don't need to do. This is raw rubber, and that gets rubber bars. And the rubber bars through the second time gives you plastic. And if you want to make plastic sheets, you need 4 plastics in a square. Right, that's 6. So we can then push these through and then become the white plastic as we need for the upgrades. Also, I wanted a nugget, didn't I? Let's make those nuggets because I need another nugget for the iron one anyway, I think. Nuggets are fairly simple to make while these are cooking. 5. 6. Good. Right. So we have the upgrades. We want the gold on first of all. Let's make that one. 2 redstone, which I, for some reason or other, didn't check. Never mind. I got 1. 1 nugget here, 3 plastics here, and redstone. Let's go and get some redstone. Redstone, of course, is now fairly straightforward. All I want to do is to make, say, 8. So I want 2 sand in there, and then simply put the recipe for redstone, which is this one, into here, and just take some straight out. Take the recipe out again, and then put the sand back in. Which is a lot easier than going with buckets right-clicking everything, isn't it? So that's this, and we've got this one. And now I also maybe want to do another. Actually, gold's okay. I don't want it too big, because it uses too much power, so let's stick with the iron upgrade. 10. Oh no, let's not. Let's go to copper. Again, it's the same stuff, and I don't have any copper with me. Oh, brilliant. It's in the chest, I hope. Has the plastic gone to? Oh, it's in place already. So just copper want. And we have a copper upgrade. So what we now do with these, if I put this into here, it'll start harvesting. Oops, yes, I'm too near the sludge boiler. I thought I moved it further away, but I haven't. Now, having done all of that, and having everything been harvested, what I have to then do is make a planter, don't I? That was very bright of me. Should have done that first, really. You see, it gives you hunger, the sludge boiler. Better not hit too often. Oops. But I would have watched out. It'll do its thing again. Where's my pickaxe gone to? Here we are. Nice new one. Right, I can reach this now. So now we can put the gold one in and get out of the way. I think it will be a good idea because that's going to start harvesting all of these aubreys here, I hope. Let's just check what's going on in here. Sort that out. Ah. What is that harvesting? It is harvesting vines. Do I still have some vines growing on this building? Oh. Got two up here. To think they're out of... Oh, maybe they're not out of reach, actually. Ah. I can still use them. Let's have a look what's going on here. Oh yes, of course, this is what's happening. So one half is for the... One half is for the trees and things, and the bottom half is for the other chest. That must have come from here. So one side was picking up... Can I get up here? Aubreys. And the other side was picking up... And they go to different halves of the chest. Like that. Okay, right, let's put my base back again. I wanted to put in some slates. I think I just want to put them in here like this. Half slabs anyway. That should make everything dark enough. It's difficult to say because I'm not 100% sure what's going on here. Oops. Sludge boiler's busy again. Let's get out of the way of sludge boiler. Maybe jump. Let's have a quick look in this chest. I've probably put an item duct in there because I don't want to be anywhere near this. You see, I've got 32 clay from this. 14 dirt. Already. I think I'll leave those in. We'll see what happens to that. Okay. Whoa. Come back out, Sigil. And I have to eat because of that food poisoning. Or... So things are working reasonably well. So next job is to make the bound blade. That takes a bit of practice too. Now what we need to do for the bound blade is have a reasonably large area. And I also have to do a planter, so I'm going to have to drag energy down here and water. Right, where am I going to do this? Maybe on here is actually a good place. Yes. So what we have to do is we simply put down the master stone. And I think I've got enough. Let me just double check. So we need... Oh no, I haven't. I need... 8, 16, 24. And I've got 16. That's what I needed these for. Let's go and make those. That'll give me another 4, and I need another 4 after that, so let's do that as well. Not sure, I haven't got that much time, but let's just see if I can do it anyway. So let's take out of here the orb, and the next thing that's coming, I should have removed those first of all, shouldn't I? Oh, so that's the last one, good. And let's put into that stone. I want 4 stone. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's get into that. Now, as soon as I start doing this, I don't do it too fast. Where is my divination signal? Yeah. See, it's 10,000. As long as I've got 8,000 in here, when these change to being, well, there should be 4,000 in there. When these change, then we have enough to carry on, so I don't need to worry about it after that. We haven't got 8,000, that's no problem. We've still got plenty of mobs there. There it goes, and that's 6,000. You don't have to kill the mobs. I filled it up again. So these will quite happily convert to reinforced. So let's get these other ones ready. So I need, I think it's this way around, and it's the apprentice blood orb I need, and obsidian. That gives me 4. That's 20. I need 24, so we should wait a second. We also need a diamond sword. So let's do that while I'm thinking about it. 1, 2, and one stick, which I don't have any of. But plenty of wood. Now plenty of sticks. Let's put that like that, and these two. Put the stick back in there. Probably should put them over there, not too much. I would think those are now done. Let's just check the blood in here. If they're not done, they should be done fairly soon. There we go. That was good timing, wasn't it? No, it's just about starting to turn there. Of course, it's put something I don't want in there, like zombie meat. Where's the orb? I don't need the magician's blood orb at the moment. Let's put that in. God, it's sloppish. Right, I'll put that in there and get rid of this. Fill up the altar again, or the blood supply. Right, job done. Food, of course, I need to eat. I should put the mob droppings away. Right, there we go. So now I have the 4. So now I've got 24, which is great. What I need now, of course, is the weak activation crystal, which is in here. The diamond sword, that's all I need. And now comes the fun bit. Now I'm going to actually, while I'm here, I'm just going to dump some of this stuff in here that I don't want. That seems like a reasonable amount of stuff. Actually, I've still got a load of stuff I don't want either. Oops, that's just... Is that finished? No, 86%. I don't need so many of these either. So let's get rid of those. Or at least I don't think I do. Probably will do when I've soon to get rid of them. I need them. Right, that's that job done. And up we go. And I think this is big enough. And all I have to do is to put the master blood orb down somewhere in the middle. Let's look around about the middle, probably around about here. There, see. Oh yes, we've got the one block up. And I don't think it goes down. We'll see in a second. If I do, then I have to put it up another block. But that's no big deal. So we then take the ritual, this thing, whatever it's called, and right click this, and then it places all the blocks in exactly the right positions. And when it's finished, it stops doing the thing. We should have none left, which we haven't. Great. So now to get this sword, what we do is we place the sword on it. Make sure I'm turned off here. In fact, let's climb up. Oh, I probably don't want to be too near this, actually. Let's turn the jetpack on. Right, let's put the sword on there, can throw it on with a Q. Hopefully it goes on, doesn't, of course. Q. Right, now it's queued. Ah, I picked it up. Didn't want to do that. It's always a bit, that's a bit of a nuisance. Let's try that again. This time it's on. Activation crystal. Right click and get out of the way. And we have a nice little firework display. Oops, I was too near. And now I should have a bound blade. And here it is. Now this uses LP from the network to kill things. Let's turn that off. And we got plenty of mobs. Let's give a quick demo. Because may cause a bad day. It's deactivated, but it's got 12 damage. So we have to right click this, I think, to bring it into our own network. And then shift right click to activate it. And then it changes shape. So you see that, it goes just a bound blade. Now it's an activated bound blade. Let's come along here and kill a few of these guys. Now we should get something different from these. And we should get little blood shards, I think they're called. But we can also, let's have a look what we have in the chest behind us. We have these weak blood shards, and these are actually necessary for the next tier of the altar. And you see also I've got a miniature red heart, a lot more droppings, and this chest is full. My goodness, that's going to be a bit of fun. Let's get rid of this because I picked up that. But we can also enchant this bound blade. Skeleton. Now they don't give any blood into the altar when I kill them like that. I have to use the other one, but that doesn't matter very much. Let's just shift that back again and swap it over. Again, if I press 1 on this thing as I'm highlighted, it moves it to that one slot. Okay. I think that's enough for now, but I will have to put some torches up here because mobs will spawn, so that's my next job. And I'll say, see you later. Until next time, bye for now.